Alrighty, folks. So I want to review with you today what's going on in the Virginia gubernatorial race and how we got here, because it is a demonstration that investigative reporting really, really, really matters. I'm going to make an open appeal right at the top. Our investigative reporter, Luke Rosiak, has been one of the key factors in shifting this Virginia gubernatorial race away from Terry McAuliffe, the former Virginia governor and former DNC head, and toward Glenn Youngkin. Like, Luke has done unbelievable work on the ground in Loudoun County, and you can see it in the polls. So let me just go through the timeline of what has happened in Loudoun County with you, so you actually know what is happening leading up to the election that is supposed to happen on Tuesday. So if you go all the way back to the beginning of this race, McAuliffe was leading by double digits. And he was up really, really big. And then in March 2021, Luke Rosiak, our investigative reporter over at Daily Wire, we vowed to you that we were going to bring you investigative reporting. That stuff is super expensive. And because of your membership, we were able to hire Luke. We want to build out that team. Luke reported in March 2021 on Loudoun County teachers who are actually compiling a list of parents disagreeing with school system actions on critical race theory. So critical race theory had become a major issue in the United States. There was a lot of talk about teaching kids about racial essentialism and teaching kids that if they were white, they were bad, and teaching them that they bore some sort of racial stigma and inherent systemic guilt and all of this. Well, the Loudoun County teachers had been getting blowback from parents who were saying, why are you teaching this stuff in the schools? So a group of parents and teachers started compiling a secret list of parents who disagreed with the school system's actions on critical race theory. And this is a report from Luke back in March of 2021, in which he reported a group of current and former teachers and others in Loudoun County compiled a lengthy list of parents suspected of disagreeing with school system actions, including its teaching of controversial racial concepts, with a stated purpose in part to infiltrate, use hackers to silence parents' communications, and expose these people publicly. Members of a 624-member private Facebook group called Anti-Racist Parents of Loudoun County named parents and plotted fundraising and other offline work. Some use pseudonyms, but the Daily Wire identified them as a who's who of the affluent jurisdiction outside D.C., including school staff as well as elected officials. This is a pretty scary thing. You had the administration, in many cases, and a radical parent body targeting parents who are upset about the indoctrination of their kids in critical race theory. Then Luke reported that the Loudoun County, Virginia school superintendent said that the First Amendment prevented him from doing anything about teacher involvement in that secret enemies list targeting parents. Well, all this began to boil over the summer as parents began to become increasingly upset with the critical race theory indoctrination they were seeing in schools. And they were going to school boards and they were sounding off. And then you'll recall that there were some school board meetings that devolved into name calling. And there was one particular school board meeting at which a parent was wrestled to the ground and arrested. And the media used this as a demonstration that Republicans, conservatives, evil conservatives in blue Loudoun County were actually getting violent with school boards. And this resulted in the National School Boards Association writing a letter to the Department of Justice and Merrick Garland, the attorney general, asking that parents be targeted as so-called domestic terrorists on the basis that they might be targeting school board members. Then Luke broke what was the biggest story of this race. So the race at this point had already been tightening, and McAuliffe had been performing very badly. The race was tightening, but up until the beginning of October, McAuliffe did have a lead in every single poll that was being taken. Then, September 28th, Terry McAuliffe, during a debate with Glenn Youngkin, made a huge mistake. He said that parents should not be in control of their kids' education.
I don't think parents should be telling schools what they should teach.
The same day, Matt Walsh of the Daily Wire went to Loudoun County. He rented an apartment for $1, and he went to Loudoun County to sound off in front of the school board about their indoctrination of their students. And here's what Matt said.
Now, you only give us 60 seconds, so let me get to the point. You are all child abusers. You prey upon impressionable children and indoctrinate them into your insane ideological cult, a cult which holds many fanatical views, but none so deranged as the idea that boys are girls and girls are boys. By imposing this vile nonsense on students to the point even of forcing young girls to share locker rooms with boys, you deprive these kids of safety and privacy and something more fundamental too, which is truth.
Just a few days later, Luke broke the biggest story of this race. It was a story titled, Loudoun County Schools Tried to Conceal Sexual Assault Against Daughter in Bathroom, Father Says. And so you'll recall, as we just discussed, that one of the people who'd been made the face of the so-called domestic terror movement was a man named Scott Smith. On June 22nd, Smith was arrested at a Loudoun County, Virginia school board meeting, a meeting that was ultimately deemed an unlawful assembly after attendees vocally opposed a policy on transgender students using the bathroom of their choice. Well, in the middle of that meeting, as it turns out, the school board superintendent got up and said that there had been no cases of sexual assault in Loudoun County school bathrooms.
Do we have assaults in our bathrooms or our locker rooms regularly? I would hope not, but I would like clarification.
To my knowledge, we don't have any records of assaults occurring in our restrooms.
Well, it turns out that that was a lie. According to Rosiak, who broke this story, again, this is what good investigative reporting means, he went to the actual horse's mouth. He went to the guy who'd been arrested, Scott Smith, and who'd been made the face of American domestic terrorism. And he found out that the reason that Smith was upset is because the school superintendent, who had said that there were no sexual assaults in the bathrooms, actually was covering up the fact that there had been an alleged sexual assault in a bathroom of Scott Smith's daughter. According to Rosiak, what people didn't know is that weeks prior, on May 28th, a boy allegedly wearing a skirt entered a girls' bathroom at nearby Stonebridge High School where he sexually assaulted Smith's ninth grade daughter. Juvenile records are sealed. Smith's attorney, Elizabeth Lancaster, told the Daily Wire a boy was charged with two counts of forcible sodomy, one count of anal sodomy, one count of forcible fellatio related to an incident that day at the school. As a result of the viral video showing his arrest, Smith became the poster child for what the NSBA since suggested could be a form of domestic terrorism, a white blue-collar male who showed up to harangue obscure public servants on his local school board. Minutes before Smith's arrest, that Loudoun County Public School superintendent lectured the public that concerns about transgender policies were misplaced because there was no record of any assault occurring in any school bathroom. It turns out that that, of course, was not true. And then a few days later, Luke Rosiak broke the news that Loudoun County overall had not been keeping track of sexual assault allegations. Not only that, it turns out that Loudoun County had taken this particular student, the one who was alleged to have committed this crime, and shifted him to another school, where once again, he had then been arrested for another case of sexual assault, allegedly. All of this led to a greater and greater pressure on Terry McAuliffe to acknowledge that parents must be in control of their kids' education and that school boards were not even doing enough to protect kids. And Terry McAuliffe just kept doubling down. He just kept saying, no, school boards need to be in control. This is all a ginned up issue. Barack Obama went to Loudoun County. And in Loudoun County, he said to the parents, he said to the people in Loudoun County who were upset over all of this, that this was fake outrage. It was not real. These social issues were not of concern. Well, they were of concern. Right now, the polls show that the number one issue for voters in Virginia is education. That is because of investigative reporting, like the stuff that we've been doing over at the Daily Wire with Luke Rosiak. Right now, as of Friday, Terry McAuliffe in the Fox News poll is down 8 points to Glenn Youngkin in a state that Joe Biden won by 10 points going away. This is why real news matters. Hey, let me just tell you, on the right, we don't do a lot of real investigative news. The reason is it's super duper expensive. And the right doesn't have huge budgets for its news portfolio. The right spends a lot of money in a lot of different places. We spend a lot of money on business. We don't spend a lot of money on investigative reporting. Because here's the thing, you might have an investigative reporter on a story for 2 months and it doesn't pan out. Or you might have an investigative reporter on a story for 6 months and it does pan out, but it's not a blockbuster story or anything. The bottom line is, it's an investment of an enormous amount of time and resources in individual stories to dig down into the nitty-gritty and get to the truth. And that's what Luke Rosiak does for us here at Daily Wire. And we want to continue building out our investigative news portfolio. The only way we can do that is with your support. Memberships make that happen. So here's the open appeal. We need you to go to dailywire.com/subscribe, and we need you to subscribe using promo code REALNEWS for 25% off. You get all the goodies at the Daily Wire site. You get the second hour of my show. You get Candace's show. You get all the other great things we got. We got Run, Hide, Fight. We got entertainment offerings that are coming very soon. We're constantly building out the portfolio of stuff that you actually get to view that nobody else does. You get to be part of All Access if you get an All Access membership and hang out with one of the hosts every night. But most importantly at all, you can make a huge difference, because when you fund the investigative news that we are doing here at Daily Wire, you help force the left to answer for its own policies. It makes a real difference. Without Luke Rosiak's reporting in Loudoun County, Glenn Youngkin is probably not up in the polls right now. Terry McAuliffe is not on the defensive, and school boards are not being held accountable. If you want more of that, please help us. We need your help. If you're not already subscribed, please subscribe right now with promo code REALNEWS for 25% off. If you are already subscribed, upgrade your subscription. That sort of revenue helps us out so we can hire more Luke Rosiaks and make sure that the truth is exposed to the public view. We can hold the left accountable, but only with your help. Again, that's dailywire.com/subscribe. Promo code REALNEWS for 25% off.